Hi, my name is Chen Hu. I'm from the Department of Dermatology from Erasmus Medical Center in Rotterdam, the Netherlands. And I'm also the lead author on the paper on eczema phenotypes during childhood and their association with environmental and genetic risk factors. And the reason that we did this study is because eczema is a common global disorder among children, and having eczema or not having eczema is an oversimplification, we think. And by taking eczema phenotypes, taking into account the age of onset and the persistence of eczema over time, better reflects the natural course and enables us to identify more specific environmental and genetic risk factors that might play a role in the development of eczema and help, hopefully, therefore also can improve eczema prevention and management strategies. Our study was embedded in the Generation R study, which is an ongoing prospective-based cohort study in Rotterdam, the Netherlands. And it has a multi-ethnic population, and around more than 5,000 children were included in our study. Our main findings are that we found five eczema phenotypes, but as you can see here, and the biggest group were the children in a never eczema phenotype group, so those have very low probability of eczema. And then there are three other small groups: early transient eczema, mid transient eczema, and late transient eczema. So these children have a high probability of eczema before the age of 2 years, around the age of 2 years, and around the age of 5 years, and then their probability declines. And the smallest group of children were the ones who had persistent eczema, who had a high probability of eczema throughout all of their life. And our association analysis showed that actually most of the previously known risk factors for eczema, such as breastfeeding and filigree mutation, they don't differentiate very well between the eczema phenotypes. So children with early transient phenotype were mostly males, and children with late transient eczema and persistent eczema were mostly of African and Asian ethnicity. So sex and ethnicity might have a predictive value for further research, but there is still much to gain to find new factors that better differentiate between the eczema phenotypes. And hopefully our results can help these future researchers develop these prediction models in order to improve the eczema management and prevention strategies.